My requests are nuts. They want me to get a piece of shit, freeze it, and then send it to them so then they can use it as a dildo. I've posted a condom full of piss and a condom full of cum. I had a wank on a train, I pissed on someone. I've got a guy who pays me for farts. Wank vids, duo wank vids, group wank vids. We're on the borderline of gay stuff, but we're not gay. They love the fact that we're straight. It's got a fantasy in their head, and a lot of them can't accept that I'm not gay. If I could poop on 5 people a week for a grand a time, I would. Like, I don't know who wouldn't. My name's Ashton Barnes, and I do OnlyFans.
The Volvic Bottle Smash for a very loyal customer. Rest in peace. I've got to pretend he's getting absolutely nailed, and this is what he likes. This is how he gets off, innit? Done. He's a sergeant major in the police. Every day of the month I had to do a shit and just record it for 700 quid. So I've got to drive as well, I pretend to run over him in a car. So I've got to sit there naked and go...
My audience is literally 99% gay men. The mates I do content with, they've all got girlfriends as well. We're on the borderline of gay stuff, but we're not gay. The amount of messages I get saying, oh, well, if you ever change your mind, ever, you never know who could be in your DMs. It could be some next billionaire, a multi-millionaire. He messaged me and all my mates. My boy's seen the DM. He's had over £750,000 in bank transfers in the last 12 months without doing anything. It's like the fact that they know we're not gay. They just love straight males. Favourite sugar daddies. You've got 2 Wall Street brokers actually from New York, a royal family member in one of the Arab countries. The other one is a multi-millionaire and he works in the weed business, a big agent in Los Angeles, and he has like personally flown me out to LA. Every single one of them are dying and wants me to fuck them. I just tease along with them and play. It's like a game of cat and mouse. Like, they know they're never gonna get it, but they just can't get over it. Arab royalty has inquired, wanted a relationship with me, which was gaining 20 grand a month, access to like a penthouse, Audi R8. He wanted to sleep with me once or twice a month. He was like, in public, we go out, we get with girls, we party, we have fun, we're best friends, and then behind closed doors, we do our thing. And I just couldn't go through with it at the time. I just knew I could make enough money without having to like sleep with guys. And I was actually homeless at this point as well. We never had much money at all growing up. Me and my mum and brother had to live in like a refuge. We moved around, went to a lot of schools. And when I was 9, my dad came back out of nowhere, came back for like 2 months, and then dipped the day before my birthday. That, I think, for me as a child, with everything else went on, set me off. I was getting pissed up, drinking when I was like 11, 12. That went on for a few years. Any money I made, I ended up just doing drugs because I was just so down and so sad. I was homeless for like 9 months. I was sleeping on a girl's sofa, and luckily this girl was like chatting to this guy. He was like, how come you're homeless? Like, what's going on? And I just told him a story and he went, bro, there's a website called OnlyFans. You should start it. This girl changed your life. I was like, fuck that. I'm not going to sell my nudes on the internet. Well, my first month I did it, I made 4.5 grand and I never looked back. Traveling, drugs, alcohol and clothes. That's what I spent all my money on. Being with her is what stopped me. If I weren't with her, I would have been sniffing last night.
Hi, I'm Nershath. I'm 20 years old.
So when you first met Ashton, how did you feel about the fact he was doing OnlyFans and getting naked for a job?
I went through his phone and I found images. I just saw him and his friend wanking next to each other. Nothing. They weren't doing anything gay.
I'm there wanking next to my mates. I'm out cold and she's not seeing this. And she goes through my phone. She brought it up to me and she went, oh, I want a new phone. And I just went,
I wasn't aware of what the industry was or what sort of things he was doing, but seeing his lifestyle and the money he was making, it sort of like made me realise it's not as negative as other people are saying as it is, and I sort of wanted to do it.
If I do one more video now of me saying, oh, I'm gonna smash his face in, stamping him, shit in his face, I'm gonna piss into a pint glass, I'm gonna pour it straight down your fucking throat, and I've just gotta go ruthless for like 2-3 minutes. And then yeah, it was about 250 to 300 just for that there. Few guys want me to be submissive and I fucking hate that. But when I've got to be the alpha and dominant and be like, oh, that's in my element, man. I would rather do that all day. Jump and beat up a Volvic bottle naked than literally wank and do other stuff. It's so much easier. So like, it's a bonus when I get these jobs. It's a bonus, isn't it?
So what's this for? On a Struno video.
It's just our OnlyFans page. But your boobs are actually massive. We're gonna actually leak them ourselves. We're gonna make accounts on all the porn sites and then get our videos uploaded, but actually put our ads. Just the average day, just getting that money in, getting content done. And especially with COVID, like all we've been doing is just sat here just on our phones working. So I found it a lot easier to speak to sugar daddies I had in America and other places because I wouldn't have to be there to meet them and stuff, so it was a lot easier.
So I'll get a bum cheek in there. It's just got jammed on my foot one sec. That's why I zipped it upwards halfway so it wouldn't get stuck on my foot and then knew it was happening. I've had to stop. I filmed a full, like, slow, like, 4-minute strip video for this guy on FaceTime and then this happened and I just fully ruined it all. I had music playing a lot.
Since I started OnlyFans, I've had 24,000 paying subscribers at 49 and over the last 3 years, like, if I kept them all, 24,000 a month would have been, like, 24,000 times 49.99, then minus 20%. It's a lot of money. For some content I film for her, same for me, like I do some on my own and she helps me.
We sort of have to be creative as well with our content, so they don't like us just always sat there posing. They want us to use food, they want us to get costumes.
I could do a chef video where I could just do a little tease there and I'll walk around and get a little apron, pretend to like cook some bits or whatever and then just end up just getting horny and then having to bust one out and jizzle over the kitchen.
Do you ever feel like you're, you know, misleading guys by, you know, posing in gay shots?
No, because if they feel like I'm misleading them, then they need to get better glasses because it's ridiculous. Because on my page, I state everything in my bio before people sign up. So I do understand if people can be a bit upset about it. But then I guess what I could say to them is read what you pay for next time. Because I'm a straight guy and it's my OnlyFans. A few people are like ridiculous on there and just are really arsy about it and I just mute them straight away.
Do you ever feel uncomfortable posing naked with your male friends?
Yeah, like Jesus, people don't understand. The only way I could, before I could, if I was with other guys, was able to get hard, was I'd have to take a Viagra and like watch porn. We're all in the same boat. People don't realise behind the scenes, we're like, fuck, oh. We do not enjoy 1 second of it. We do it because we think, fuck, let's make a fuckload of cash and just get it done with. Like, there's not been one time that I know me and my mates have ever enjoyed filming one video. Gay boy, ha ha ha. You need serious help, you faggotron. You'd probably rather have men's cock in your ass than work a normal job. Luckily, I can take a lot of shit and take on the chin, but deep down, it's not nice at all. I am just a normal human being. All you people who said shit about us and said them nasty things about us, and you don't know shit, you don't know who we are, you don't know what we're about, you don't know what we've been through, you don't know what we plan on doing with all this money. And I guarantee you, we're gonna do more with all this money than the majority of you lot put together.
Literally,
all together. Money isn't everything, but money makes the world go round.